Right, hello and welcome to Totally Scale Models. My name's Steve. Just like to say, hope you've all had a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year coming up, 2019. Let's have a good one. This is going to be a bench update. Not done a video for a while. I apologise. Had some life issues, shall we say, going on. Real world problems. So I'm going to try and show what I've been doing. I have been doing some modelling, not prolific. Never have been a prolific model builder. So I'm going to try and show what I have been doing and some of the builds that I've practically completed and some that I haven't. I sort of started and sort of like, meh. Okay, so I'm going to go over to the bench and have a look. Right, so this was the Mustang I did for Paul Bretland's muscle car build. Didn't completely finish it, didn't glue down the hood or the bonnet, however you want to call it. To be honest, I got a bit fed up with it. I did the 2K on it and didn't come out as well as I expected it to. It does look quite shiny here. Yeah, and it has got a nice shine on it, but on closer inspection you can see where there's some flaws on the roof there and a little bit on the back. There's a bit of orange peel on there as well, and on here, and there's a really bad mark on the wing. Not too bad, you know, it all opens up and you can see inside. It is 1/16 scale now, as you can see that just parts just falling off. I have struggled with this gluing parts on. It just doesn't want to glue no matter what I try to do. I'm gonna have to put that somewhere now. Putting the bits, the rear spoilers, if that's what you call them, I don't know, fenders, bottom part, I don't know, but they didn't want to glue properly. I didn't even put the headlights in because by this point I just got, you know what, I've had enough. Engine, got some nice engine detail in there. I used the chrome pens, if I can find it. Probably not now. It'd be typical, you know, you want to try and find something and you can't when you need it. No, don't know what I've done with that now. But anyway, yeah, so I used the chrome pens. Nice, very good. I managed to get a lot of the chrome work, bright work done on here, and the lettering on the side and on there, bits and pieces, and all around the windscreens and the windows, if you want to call it that. And I did some on the engine, and I also did the Ford lettering in on the front as well with it. Now I'm not sure where I put them chrome pens now, that's gonna bug me now. Whoops, sorry, shouldn't have done that. So yeah, that was the Mustang build. It's not too bad. I just don't think cars are my thing. I had to really tough around with the wheels at the back because just didn't come out right. And now when you look at it, you probably can't see it off that side. You can, the wheel sticks outside from the wheel arch, so I don't know. And now you can see that's just come away again. So yeah, I'm going to put this down before I totally destroy it. I'm going to put that up there out of the way, so we'll be back in a second. Right, so another kit I'm doing, and I'm actually still in the process of doing this, but I am getting to the point where I'm like, this is taking some time now, and I've made a few mistakes on it. But this is the Avro, well, sorry, it's the Revel 172 Avro Shackleton. Kit's very nice, actually. It's operator error that has been making mistakes. So a bit of a Dinlow. There you go. It's all been put together, primed in UMP primer, and then I used their the call out colours for mixing the paints to do the top coat. But I feel it is a little bit dark from what it looks like. I'm not sure, but it's just me. It was all masked up. But what I have noticed, that when I put a matte coat on this, I think maybe I was a bit too close, but I bought like a it's made it quite lighter there. So a bit of a dinner there. Got the rear, the glass on the rear to put on, and the wheels are all done, the insides are done. Well, I don't know if you call that a bomb bay or not, because I don't think it actually did carry bombs, I don't know. Wheel landing gear was done. I did have a problem with landing gear, I broke part of it, but I've managed to glue it on. And then the flaps were all painted internally with the white. So yep, that's that. Another problem I did have is with the glass there, it's sort of like got pushed inside, that one and that one, and the door got pushed in with my heavy fingers and thumbs. Some of the poseable, but none of that is that. They were, but then they fell out, so I've had to glue them in. So I have, probably won't come up, but it is painted black on there, which is what the call out calls out. But because the camera's not gonna bring it out too bad very well, but there is in life, real life, not real life, but in off camera, you can see there is a distinction between the grey and the black. So what's left to do on this? I have the props to do. I've started doing the props, but again, seeing with these, they have to be painted red. Now I thought, oh, I can hand paint them and they'd be all right, but they're not. So I'm just going to leave it. I've got to paint a little white line on each one, and then they will go on along with the caps that are on there, and then it's just down to decals to do the decals, 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 whatever you want to call them. And then I'm going to call that done. Now what I did receive, I'm part of a Secret Santa, and I received some PE for this. This has got a PE cockpit interior detail set inside, but someone sent me some more PE for this. But by this point I'd already completed the build, more or less, the building process. So I have bought another, it's not there, but that's not the one, but I have bought another Shackleton. And let me just turn that on. Yeah, so you've got the box there, but that's not the one. I have bought another Shackleton, and to go with all that PE, and I'm going to do that again later next year, maybe 2019. Sorry, I do apologize for the yawning there. How unprofessional, how rude. So that is what, something I'm going to do 2019, hopefully. So I'm just going to carry on with this and use what I've done with this as a learning curve, so that hopefully when it comes to doing the new one, the next one in next year, I can make a much better job of it. So yeah, I am quite pleased with this. It's probably my first aircraft that I've completed, so to speak. I did do the Airfix 124 scale, but never completed it because it's a rotten kit. Well, some will say it's a rotten kit. I think it's a wrong kit, but some will say it's not. So no, not too pleased with this. I found that, well, normally most people know that I do sci-fi, and well, I'm actually quite liking it, so much so that for Christmas I asked for a couple of aircraft kits. I've also bought an aircraft kit as well, which is something I can show later in an update. Let's just pause there for one. So let's just move on to the next thing. So earlier this year, as most people know, we had Telford. I didn't do a video this year. Was planning to do a video before Telford, some video of Telford, and then after Telford video, so to speak, but didn't do it this year. I took some pictures, not many. Had a bit of a nightmare actually going to Telford. I ended up dropping my iPad and smashing that, so, and then I've had no phone for some time due to I smashed that as well. So a bit of a pants time with phones and pads. And also I have some medical problem which reared up as well, so wasn't feeling totally. Enjoyed Telford, did enjoy it. Didn't stay as long as I wanted to this year due to things, but bought a couple of kits, and one of them is the Meng D9R bulldozer. I've seen this built before, and it's, I know it's an old kit ish but I do like it. It looks quite interesting. So yeah, I bought that, and I'm thinking, not might not do, but thinking that I might try and actually light it, because you've got some lights up in here and here, and then probably a red one on the back for the rear. So yeah, thinking about it, so much so thinking about it, I've actually bought some pre-wired micro SMDs that can go in there. I've just got to really think about wiring it. And yet again, someone saw that I had bought this as well, same per Secret Santa, and they've got me some photo etch, which is the photo etch frame, armored slat framing to go around. So rather than having the plastic one, I'm gonna have the PE stuff. Yeah, thanks. I'm probably going to make a review of this kit. I know it's an old kit, I know other people have done it, but I'm going to try and get some videos going out there. Not sure when that will come out, but I will do. So that's that kit. So here is another kit. This is what kit I got for Christmas from my wife, and it's the Tamiya F-14D Tomcat 148 scale, as you can see. Saw this at Telford, looks really really good, a lot of detail. And again, as I've said, I've been doing the Shackleton. I was quite liking the plane sort of thing, so I looked into this and I got to get it for me along with PE. So I've got a PE cockpit set, and I think there's some stuff for the engines, and I've also got the resin set of wheels, and I think there's some other bits and pieces PE as well. It looks a lovely kit inside. Have looked at it, looks very very nice. I've been told so much about Tamiya kits, never built a Tamiya kit before, but yeah, so I've got that, and I intend to build that this year, or not this year, 2019 as well, along with the Meng kit. What all do I do these in? I don't know. I'm not going to say I'm going to build this then, this now, this then, this then, etc. etc. because I don't think you can. I've tried to do a schedule of builds for this year, but it just didn't happen. So yeah, that was going to be my another plane kit. Well, a plane kit. This looks very nice. There's a lot of detail on it. I think there's three or four paint schemes you can do. One of them being the Grim Reaper, which I like the sound of. So yeah, I'm probably gonna do that one. And so we have here the new tooling of the Tamiya Spitfire. This is the 148 scale again. I quite like that sort of scale. I think it's I've got fat thumbs, so it's a little bit bigger than 172. I did find that the Avro Shackleton was a bit small for me, shall we say. So I like the 148. So this is the new tooling I've just noticed in these videos you can't see my face in this. Maybe that's not a bad thing, I don't know. So yeah, the new kit came out on the 17th of December this year. Looks very nice kit. Got a few colour schemes and markings in there. So this was the first Tamiya kit I bought. I will do a review of this, but not many parts. Does it say many parts? Probably does somewhere, but because I don't really know how to read these kits that well, I just don't feel. But there's one, two, three bags, and then some decals and some clear plastic. I am going to do a review of this this kit, and again I know it has been reviewed already, but I want to do it because I'm just going to try and build the channel up. 1 foot scale aircraft series number 119. Yeah, it doesn't seem any part. Well, it probably does, but I can't remember. Oh, bit of awkward silence. No. Got a bit rendered in detail. Choose your open close canopy. Yeah. Sorry. Do apologise for that. That's an alarm. I'm on some medication to take some meds. So, yeah, so that is that. Right, so that's some of the kits I've got. I did record a little bit of video of the Enterprise. She's all completed and done. I'll try and include that video on this. I am pleased with it. It's taken a hell of a long time to build, but it is a massive kit. I thought, in hindsight, I'm glad I bought it. I'm glad I did it. Perhaps I should have just bought it and left it for some time, and got some more modelling skills better going and achieving, and then it wouldn't have taken me so long to do it. But now I am pleased with it. There are quite a few mistakes actually, which I noticed, but people, like when I've shown pictures of it, people go, "Oh, it looks great, it's fantastic," and yeah, it is, but I can see the mistakes and everything. Decals breaking, some painting, bad joins, etc. But overall, I'm really pleased with it. I think I've done some good lighting in it. Got a couple of lighting balls in there. One from Jennifer at Small Scale Lights, and another one, can't quite remember where I got the one from, but it's just for the nav lights on the side. But yeah, overall, really pleased with it. So I'm going to show that video, and then we'll be back. Right, so here is the Enterprise, all completely finished. This is in the front room at the moment, on top of a display cabinet. I'm pretty pleased with her. She does look good. You can see the registry on the front there. There's a few mistakes which I've seen, which I've done, which, you know, can't do anything about it now, but as a whole, yeah, I'm pretty pleased. You can see inside the arboretum, it's pretty cool in there. You've got the torpedoes firing on the front there. We've got the orange flashing, which is just remembering thruster, representing thruster engines. Got the strobe effect on there, which is very good. We've got multiple strobes all around the model. We've got the registry on the front, as again, lights coming out. I know the back there isn't done properly. I should have some more decals on there. And I did have some problem with that red line going round, and I know now it's in the wrong place, but there you go, it's too late now. Enterprise on the back there. Painted
a bit of a weird paint job there, but got the nacelles painted in the blue, with a blue light inside. Again, I think you've got again, you've got the strobes on the back of the saucer section and the impulse engines. Again, more strobe on the back there with the thruster flashing. The NEC on the back, NCC sign on the back. So yeah, I'll put it in. One of my favourite things is the shuttle bay. Now I know the colour bits around here, these bits of glass around here should be coloured, but I didn't do that right and I just want to get it done. But no, I am pleased with the inside of that, it looks quite cool. And then so looking from the back, you can see you got the other back behind the Eagle, quite pleased with that as well. But we're not looking at that, we're looking at the Enterprise. And yeah, I'm pretty pleased with her. She sits proud on top of my display cabinet for the moment. It's not on, it's not turned on. But so overall, I'm pretty pleased with her. Big kit, big model kit. Took me a long time to do it, but I did it in dribs and drabs. So overall, I'm pleased. There are some, I had some major mistakes with the decals. You can see there where they broke. Yeah, they were a problem. All the Aztecs are done. Again, that's all using the decals. I didn't paint any of those. It's all decals. And then the grey sections, little dots that I painted. So yeah, that's my Enterprise. The USS Enterprise refit.
Right, so hopefully you've seen the video of the Enterprise now. Hopefully you liked it. Anyway, so that will should conclude this video for this month, and if I get it up in time this year. So if you are watching this often, wishing you all a happy new year, hope you had a great Christmas. My intention for 2019: build more, do more videos. I mentioned once before, just build and then do voiceover. Didn't really get around to doing that. Had a few problems health wise, and Mojo took a bit of a didn't really want to do any recording. I just wanted to sit there and build sometimes and just not video anything. Also, I'm not that technically minded when it comes to stuff like that, so doing these videos can be a chore sometimes. I want to do them, I have in my head what I want to achieve, but I lack the technical know-how of how to achieve it. I've got what I believe is a decent editing software. It's just me, just being a dillo. So that side of things. Medical side of things, I've got my normal stuff that people know about. But I was told last month that I had to have a toe removed due to infection, and that did sort of like knock me for six. I had an infection, and this is what also caused me some problems at Telford, so I was a bit like, so I've been feeling down in the dumps about that. Just stuff, life really, and then busy at work, family, kids and stuff like that. So but gonna try and get on. New year, people say new year, new me. You say old me. Just gonna just try and do some more building and some more videoing. And hopefully I'm going to try and put some videos in the can, so to speak, and then get them released over time. So I'm going to try and do some more reviews. I'm not someone that's going to go out and buy a new kit for the sake of buying a new kit, for the sake of just doing a review for it. So, oh, let's get it out before anybody else does. I can't afford to do that. And also, I buy what I want to build. I'm not going to buy in stuff that I might build that, I might not. I've bought stuff that I wish to build. I was mainly sci-fi, but I must admit I am turning to a little bit of military within the planes. I do quite like the planes, they're looking quite nice. Hence the reason why I've got the Tomcat and the Spitfire, and also everyone's got to build a Spitfire, haven't they? And I tried to build that 124 Spitfire. It's still out there. I might come back to it. I've said that about a million times, I think. And that bulldozer, it did look nice. So my intention, famous last words, is I'm not going to be, my intention is not to be buy any more kits up until at least Telford 2019. I need to concentrate on buying equipment, paints and tools and stuff like that. I'm not gonna say I've got an extensive paint range, I've got a fairly good paint range, but compared to what's out there and compared to what other people have got, I've got nothing complete. Something I have been doing, I will put some pictures up of the cave or my workbench area. I've been buying some of the Hobby Zone modules, and I actually quite like them. They look quite smart. Having to change the desk around slightly, just move some of the paint racks up a bit to accommodate them, but I like them, the drawers. I've got now 7 modules in total, and I want to buy 2 more, I've got 8 modules, sorry, because I've got paintbrush holder and everything there, so I've got 8, but I want to buy 2 more, which will go here underneath the screen, my work screen. After that, not sure. I do know I need to, if I'm going to build up my Tamiya paints, I do need to build bigger paint racks, but that's something in the future. Something I do want to do later this year is get a new shed. It's getting a bit tired, this shed. I've had this shed 8 years nearly. Sorry about that. I've had this shed 8 years, I think. We had it where we used to live down in West London. Took it apart, put it up here, put it together, and it's a bit lopsided. That's me, because I just chucked it in, so my bench sort of like goes down a bit. It's got a few holes in it and everything, and it's just starting to show a few signs of wear. It's quite a few, and I would like to get a new shed later this year, so a bigger shed, give me a bit more room. And if I do that, I will totally redesign my complete workbench area, using the modules, the Hobby Zone modules, and my own built paint racks, and have it totally set out, so it's all really nice. It looks nice as it is, but I just want to make it look even nicer. Spray booth in a separate area, and some nice under counter drawers and units that I can get to easily. That is my bench update, my final video for 2018. Thank you for joining. Please like, subscribe. That would be great. Also, we do have the Facebook group of the same name, Totally Scale Models. So please look for that. Come and join us. Post builds. I post fairly regularly. We get a few other people posting regularly. And then on a Saturday night, we do put up a link for our hangouts. We do an off-air hangout on a Saturday night, normally around about 8 o'clock. There's 3 of us main guys that do it, because we've got I have a group. A friend of mine, James Skiffin, has his group. Probably heard of it. It's the Model Officers Mess. And then we have Carl Smith, who has his group, which is Making Models. And the 3 of us all get together and we do this off-air hangout on a Saturday night, and we post links post links on the daytime, same with doing them, and then we post a link up to the hangout around about 8 o'clock on a Saturday night. Pretty much most Saturdays. And it'd be great to see people come, more people come and join us. Just so that we don't go live, although we are tending to go live at some point later in the year, but that's to do with James's model officers mess more than TSM. So, but yeah, so please come along, give us a come and join us one night, you know, bit of banter, just sit here modeling, chatting. All you need is a camera and a microphone. You don't have to be separate, you can use an iPad or an iPhone, they tend to work as well. So yeah, please do come along. But I'm gonna say goodbye. I'm dribbling now, drifting off and talking waffling. So thanks for watching. Hopefully it's come out all right, and I'll see you all in the new year with a new build. Thanks a lot. Bye.